Hi, I'm disability lawyer David Brannon. This is just a quick video to talk about the importance of documents at your Social Security Tribunal hearing. Now, after watching this video, you will appreciate why documents are so important and why you need to avoid the mistake of not having the right documents. Now, if you like this video, hit that like button. Don't forget to subscribe, hit the bell notification so you get notice of these videos when they come out a few times a week. I cannot stress enough how important documents are for the success of your CPP disability claim at the Social Security Tribunal. The documents that you send in will become part of an official record called the hearing file, and I've covered that in other videos, but in a nutshell, any document you send in will be stamped, become part of this hearing file. The judge can only consider documents that are part of the official hearing file. Anything else is like it doesn't exist. Now, the number one mistake we see people make at this stage when representing themselves at the Social Security Tribunal is not getting in the right documents or enough documents or any documents at all. People tend to think that they're going to be able to go in there and just rely on they're just going to go in and tell their story and that should rule the day. Your testimony is not as important as the documents that you should be putting in there. You should be telling your story through documents, not going in and trying to carry all the water yourself. That's a recipe for disaster. You are not as credible as a lot of the documents that you can get. Now, what types of documents am I talking about? There's two basic types of documents. There are documents that were created in what's called the normal course of business. These would be documents that have nothing to do with your case. They were your past medical records before this case even happened, your employment records before this case even happened, records from pharmacies or any other source that have really nothing to do with this case that would have been created whether you had this case going on or not. The second type of documents are documents created for this case and claim. That's when your doctor filled out a form for the CPP application, your doctor or other health professionals wrote letters to support your claim. Those are a different type of document. Those are records that are created for this claim, but don't over-rely on documents only created for this claim. You need to have a good mix of documents that were just created out there that will tell the story, a lot of historical records from your medical records and that type of thing. In many ways, those documents will be seen as more believable and credible because there was no intention to try to have anything to do with this claim. You are gonna need specific documents related to this claim to kind of fill the gaps, answer certain specific questions and the like. So you need a mix of both of these types of documents. To summarize, the biggest mistake we see people make is not getting enough of both of these types of documents to support their claim, and you do not want to fall into that situation. So what do? You have to focus on reviewing your case and identifying what are going to be the key documents that I need to support my claim. Here is that you need to know how important these documents are and understand that you have to focus on identifying and obtaining the documents necessary to win your case. Now, if you like this video, please hit the like button. Don't forget to subscribe, hit the bell notification so you'll get notice of these videos when they come out a few times a week. Good luck with your claim.